I'm always interested in new approaches that aim to solve problems the tech world currently has. Search engines, for example, seemingly have to make a trade-off. Either use online tracking with significant privacy issues to provide the most relevant results, like Google, or provide less personalized but private results, like DuckDuckGo and Startpage. This is where the private search startup Xayn caught my eye. I think that's how you pronounce it. It attempts to personalize search results by having the user swipe relevant results to the right and irrelevant websites to the left, much like how the dating app Tinder works, and without collecting any personal information. So far, Xayn is only available for mobile devices, but a browser extension is in development. The app consists of several tabs: a home screen with news articles, search history, the search tab with the ability to filter images, videos, and news, a bookmark library, and some settings. The brain icon in the top right corner disables the search AI to display unfiltered results. To train the AI, which runs locally on the device, interaction with the search results is necessary. Swipe away any unwanted websites and confirm relevant content. This is also where you can bookmark and share websites. At least on iOS, the app animations seem to stutter a little. Hopefully that will be improved with time. Also, a window to undo the last action pops up after each decision. Let's see how it works in practice. Say I'm looking for Java, the island, not the programming language. The default algorithm seems to prefer the software Java, so I'll train the AI to prefer the island. After a few swipes, let's search for Java again. It seems to be working. This time, Java, the island, is the first result. To make single searches like this part of a larger contribution to the search algorithm, according to Xayn, every once in a while, all local AIs combine their search models into a global one without exchanging personal data. Everything is supposed to be end-to-end encrypted. They published a whole white paper about the technical details. Since Xayn doesn't display ads, at least currently, the company is planning a paid version for companies and government agencies to search their internal documents. I'm convinced many users would rather have instant relevant answers instead of having to train their personal algorithm first. Currently, I see Xayn as a neat concept that is able to offer more personalized search results than other private search engines, but I doubt many people are willing to constantly evaluate search results when more convenient but less private alternatives are just a click away. I already mentioned in my video about DuckDuckGo that while their commitment to privacy is commendable, their search results are often subpar. Maybe Xayn's approach could also help improve search results for other competitors to Google once their AI is trained well enough. Their so-called Federated Learning Framework for privacy-preserving AI applications is open source, available on GitHub. By the way, if you haven't seen the video about Project Turtledove, Google itself is also developing new alternatives to today's online tracking. Even they seem to notice a shift in users' expectations. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.